Hello, this is Mario from ODEON. In this video, we would like to show you two of ODEON's visualization tools, which are 3D Investigate Rays and 3D Billiards. 3D Investigate Rays is a way to visualize ray tracing, allowing you to follow the full reflection path of each single ray. This is a useful tool to check whether your geometry is watertight or has unexpected holes in it. Or if sound can propagate appropriately from your source's position. This is a tool available in every edition of ODEON. 3D Billiard visualizes sound as, you guessed it, billiards. This tool allows you to identify acoustic effects such as flutter echoes, focusing, and how surface size affects scattering. And like 3D Investigate Rays, it can also be used to find holes in the geometry. Aside from the practical uses, it's also just a nice animation to look at. It can help people not familiarized with acoustics to understand propagation of sound. 3D Billiard is available in editions Industrial, Auditorium, and Combined. Now, let's go into detail about how to use these tools. You will find 3D Investigate Rays on the icon bar at the top. There are some settings to enter before running it. You can select whether to use your surface's actual scattering, no scattering, or full scattering. This is useful to study how much difference it makes to have even just a little bit of scattering. This number of rays is how many rays will be emitted from the source. The maximum reflection order and the impulse response length will be stop criteria for each single ray, meaning a ray will stop propagating once either of the two criteria is reached. Here, you can select which of your sources to use. You will see the selected source in red in the 3D view. The maximum damping is yet another stop criterion for each ray, in case you want to stop the rays once they have attenuated by a certain amount. Before we explain the rest of the settings, let's watch the visualization. We can accept the settings by clicking OK. On this next screen, you can run the visualization in steps or non-stop. Let's go through a few reflections with the single forward button. Also, notice how the values update with each step. You can trace back with the single back button, though this will only recolor the reflection path without erasing it. We can also run full rays with the single ray button. You can run the visualization nonstop with the free run button. You can stop the visualization with this button. And you can resume from this current moment. Let's go back to the settings by clicking abort. You can start midway through the visualization with this started ray parameter. To understand how this is different from just using less rays, we will explain the pattern in which the rays are emitted. Rays are emitted from the source following a spiral, first emitting upwards and working its way down. The number of rays will determine the resolution going down this path, but all possible directions will be evenly distributed. By entering a number in the start at ray field, you will start from some point of this spiral. For example, if you're interested in showing the horizontal rays, you could enter a number slightly below half the total number of rays. With this checkbox, only lost rays will stay drawn, making them easier to identify if that's what you're interested in. And finally, this is how often the wireframe of the model will be drawn back on top of the ray tracing lines, in order to avoid letting the model get covered behind the rays. Now, let's take a look at 3D Billiard. We will click on this 3D Billiard icon. As soon as you open the window, the animation will start with the default settings. Right now, the colors show reflection order. Again, your first option here is to select the behavior of scattering, which is especially noticeable in this visualization. Here, you can select the plane in which the billiards will be emitted. These planes are absolute, but you can align the planes to the source with this checkbox. For example, here, my source has some elevation, so by clicking the checkbox, the planes will be tilted upwards. You can also emit billiards in random three-dimensional directions. As we have seen, changing the settings restarts the animation. But down here, we also have some buttons to restart, run, stop, and advance in steps. In ODEON Auditorium and Combined, you can define certain surfaces as reflectors. If you have done this, then you can visualize only the billiards that will bounce off reflectors. This is an alternate way of viewing reflector coverage. Remember that you can also toggle interior and exterior surfaces with the T shortcut. This could help you get a clearer view. Here, we can change the number and size of billiard balls. This parameter is the distance traveled by each ball between each frame of the animation, which basically determines the speed of the animation. The maximum reflection order and maximum decay are stop criteria, just as we explained for 3D Investigate Rays. When a billiard ball reaches either, it will disappear from the animation. The Show Absorption checkbox will have the animation use colors for decay due to reflections instead of reflection order. you will also gain access to some other options. This checkbox is to include spherical decay, that is, the decay of sound due to propagation. For large rooms, this could be relevant, but if you are only interested in the decay from reflections, you could leave it unticked. The absorption shown is broadband, which can be linear or A-weighted. You can also look at the absorption in a single octave band. Here, you can change the color scale. Finally, here you can select a different source to emit the billiard balls. With that, we conclude this tutorial, and we hope you have found it useful. Good luck!